So first column is sources, which is already given in the question. Second column, amount of the sources, which is also available in the question. Next column will be proportion. Next column will be COC. It should be in the form of percentage. And the last column will be VAT. It should be also in the form of percentage. Always remember, VAT is also in the form of percentage. Now, what are the sources available? 7% debentures, 8% written shares. So we will write as it is, 7% debentures. Okay. What is the amount of debentures? 1,30,000 rupees. See, it is so easy. I will tell you, 1,30,000 rupees. Okay. Now, next is 8% preference share. Capital. I'm writing short form, but you don't have to write short forms. You guys have to write full forms.
70,000.
What is the amount? 70,000. Very good.
70,000.
Very good. So next is we have equity share capital. What is equity share capital? What is the amount of equity share capital?
6 lakhs.
6 lakhs. And what is the total of all? We need total also, huh? We need one more.
8 lakhs.
Yes, we need to write the total. So company's total capital is 8 lakhs. Out of 8 lakhs, 1,30,000 is debentures, 70 is preference shares, 6 lakhs is equity share capital. So how will you calculate the proportion? Can anybody tell me how to calculate proportion? Yes, will you be able to tell me? See how to calculate. You have to take each amount divided by total, divide it with the total, and after dividing it with total, multiply that amount with 100. Very simple. See, if you want to calculate the proportion of debenture, the proportion of debentures. So how will you do that? 1,30,000 divided by total 8 lakhs into 100. If you want to go with preference shares. So 70,000 divided by 8 lakhs into 100. Because out of 8 lakhs, it is 70,000, no? So 70,000 divided by 8 lakhs into 100. Are you getting my point? Say at least yes, no? Okay. So if you want to calculate for equity, it would be 6 lakhs divided by 8 lakhs into 100. So go on telling me, come on, take up the calcis in your hand. 1,30,000 divided by 8 lakhs into 100.
Ma'am, 16.25.
It is 16.25. Very good. 16.25 what? Percentage. So 70,000 upon 8 lakhs into 100.
8.75%.
Very good. 8.75%. Next. 6 lakhs divided by 8 lakhs into 100. What is 6 lakhs divided by 8 lakhs into 100?
75%.
Very good, 75%. And if you add up these percentages, it will be definitely 100%. You guys don't have to add. But if you go on adding this, it will definitely be 100%. Because 8 lakhs is assumed as 100% only. No. We are going to divide with the whole amount, which is 8 lakhs. So, of course, these percentages will be equals to 100% only. Okay. What is COC of 7%? What is COC of debentures?
7%.
Yes. Now, 7% is before tax. Huh? Because always remember, debentures are before tax. The rate of interest which is given to the debenture holders is always before tax. But VAT, in the question, they don't tell you anything. They don't ask you anything about the nature of VAT. Have they given calculate VAT before tax, after tax? Have they given such sentence? No. If they are not giving you such type of sentences, then it is understood that you need to calculate it after tax. But debentures, the interest of debentures is before tax. Then do we need to convert it into after? Yes, we need to convert. What was the after tax formula? I1 minus T. I is 7%. I is interest rate. interest rate is 7%. 1 is already standard minus T. Now T is given in the question. Is tax rate given in the question? T is tax rate.
No, ma'am.
No. And also they have written here, ignore taxation. Ignore tax. They are already giving you the hint here that I know debenture rate of interest is before tax. I know you need to convert, but still ignore taxation. They are giving you hint here. Therefore, right now in this sum, you just have to copy down 7%. Otherwise, see, otherwise, if ignore taxation was not written here, and if they were to give you the tax rate, suppose 30%, then you would have been solving it and converting it into the after tax. You would be doing it. Okay. Agar aisa diya hoga to.
I'm repeat.
मेरी बात सुनो, आपको इस सम में क्या बोला है? इग्नोर टैक्सेशन बोला है ना. देखो जो डिबेंचर्स होते हैं ना, डिबेंचर्स उनको जो हम रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट देते हैं ना, वो बिफोर टैक्स होता है. ये मैं आपको पहले समझा चुकी हूँ. जो डिबेंचर होता है उसका रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट होता है वो बिफोर टैक्स होता है. बाई इट्स नेचर इट इज बिफोर टैक्स. बट जब बैक कैलकुलेट करते हैं तो हमको सब कुछ आफ्टर टैक्स लेना होता है. डू यू अग्री?
यस मैम.
तो अब 7% तो बिफोर टैक्स है, तो मुझे आफ्टर टैक्स में कन्वर्ट करना है. हाँ जी, बिल्कुल करना है. कन्वर्ट करने के लिए फॉर्मूला क्या है? आई वन माइनस टी. आई कितना है? 7%. वन माइनस टी. टी कितना है? पता नहीं, सब में दिया ही नहीं है. तो दिया ही नहीं है, जीरो है ना. वन माइनस टी है जीरो. टी है जीरो, तो जीरो कैसे मैं फॉर्मूला में ले सकती हूँ? फॉर्मूला ही नहीं लगाऊंगी ना मैं. तो एज इट इज 7% लेंगे. और उसने दूसरी बात ये कहा भी तो है, इग्नोर टैक्सेशन. ये देखो यहाँ पे पढ़ो, इग्नोर टैक्सेशन कहा भी तो है. तो मतलब अभी के लिए इस सम में हम 7% को सेम रखेंगे. देखो सॉल्यूशन 7% को सेम रखा है ना इसने. नहीं समझ में आया आप लोगों को?
समझा मैम, समझा.
हाँ, दिस इज व्हाट आई एम सेइंग. ओके, सो 7% इज सेम. अदरवाइज हर सम में सेम ही रखना है. हर सम में टैक्स अगर दिया होगा तो कन्वर्ट करना है. यहाँ पे तो टैक्स दी हुई नहीं है ना. द टैक्स इज नॉट गिवन. हाउ वी विल कन्वर्ट? इफ टैक्स इज गिवन वी विल हैव टू कन्वर्ट. ओके, नाउ प्रेफरेंस शेयर कैपिटल. द डिविडेंड व्हिच इज गिवन टू प्रेफरेंस शेयर कैपिटल इज आफ्टर टैक्स, राइट? इट इज ऑलवेज आफ्टर टैक्स. एंड वी वॉन्ट आफ्टर टैक्स ओनली. वी वॉन्ट आफ्टर टैक्स ओनली. So 8% is right. Okay. What about equity shareholders? Now read
10%.
No. We will have to understand it. The formula is there. We need to apply the formula and then calculate the answer. See, I will tell you. Dividend of 10% has been paid to equity shareholders. This is DPS. Dividend to equity shareholder. DPS upon MPS into 100. You remember the formula? Just now I cleared, ma'am. No? KE formula is DPS upon MPS into 100 plus G. G is not given. Growth rate is not given in the question. So leave it. Growth rate, leave it. What has to be taken in the formula then? DPS upon MPS into 100. So what is DPS? 10% is given, no? We need to convert it, okay? 10%, we need to convert it. It is percentage. We need to convert it into amount. Now, what about market price? The hint is given. See, the prices of these securities, last sentence. The prices of these securities have recently been at par. That means market value and the face value is same. They are giving you the hint that market value is equals to face value. What is the face value of equity shares? Look at the question. Equity shares of rupees 100 face value.
100 face value.
It is given. Everything is given. You just have to understand. It is an hidden adjustment. You will have to understand. So face value is 100. Last line mein likha hua hai, face value is equals to market value. Therefore, market value is 100. Okay, market value. I got MPS. Now, what about DPS? What is DPS? 10%. Always remember, dividend is calculated on face value. Always remember, dividend is calculated on face value. What is face value?
100.
100 into 10%. Dividend is 10%. No. So 10% on face value. 10% on 100 rupees. So 100 on, what is 10% of 100?
Lakh.
Oh my God.
1 lakh.
What is 10% of 100 rupees?
Sorry. 10 rupees.
Yes. Very good. So here I will have to calculate the formula. See, K, E. But this E will have to be written at the foot of K. See, this way. This is the way you have to write. This should be the way that you have to write. Can you see? K, uske niche, uske pairon mein, uske foot mein, E. Aisa likhte hai usko. Achha, ab formula kaise likhenge? Formula to normal jaise likhte hai. DPS divided by MPS into 100. Dekho kitni simple formula hai. Vaise yahan pe ye pura bracket mein aata hai, phir bahar likhte hai plus G. Par growth rate hai hi nahi na. Jab hai hi nahi, to main likhu kyun? Theek hai? चलो बोलो डीपीएस कितना है 10. कैसे निकाला ये 10 कोई बताएगा ये 10 कैसे अभी निकाला
100 पे 10%.
हाँ तो ब्रैकेट में मैं आपके लिए लिख रही हूँ. हाँ 100 इनटू 10%. सो ये मैंने आप लोगों के लिए लिखा है ये कैसे निकालना है ये. ठीक है तो मैं 10 को नहीं यहाँ पे शिफ्ट कर देती हूँ. ठीक है 10 डिवाइडेड बाय अब ये 10 कैसे आया 100 into 10% divided by what is MPS? MPS is equals to face value. It is given in the given at the last line of the question. Market value is equals to face value. It is already given. So face value is 100. Market value is also 100. Into 100 because we want to convert this formula into percentage. So 10 upon 100 into 100. What is the percentage of KE? What is the percentage
100%.
Of K? 100. Very good. No. 10 upon 100 into 100 is 100. Guys, please Zero. Answer me properly.
10.
Yes. 10. So this 10% will come here. The percentage which is calculated in the working note number 1, this is, take this as working note number 1. Take this as working note number 1. So working note number 1, KE is 10%. So you will have to keep this 10% as according to working note number 1. And you don't need to make the total of this. Never make the total of column of COC of COC in the form of percentage. Never. Now come to VAT. How to calculate VAT? There is a formula. Just give me a second. So to calculate VAT, there is this very simple formula. Very, very simple formula. See, this is column number 1. This is column number 2. This is column number 3. This is column number 4. So this is just for you. Huh? Don't write it in paper. This bracket is just for you. Column number 3 into column number 4. This is the formula of VAT. That's it. See how simple it is. See how simple it is. VAT is column number 3 into column number 4. What is column number 3? Proportion. What is column number 4? Percentage of COC. Are you guys getting me? Are you guys following me? Please reply.
Ma'am, repeat karo na.
Yes, ma'am.
Column number 3, proportion. Column number 4, COC. Multiply both of the columns, you will be getting VAT. Abhi ek aur baar repeat karun. Annu, ek aur baar repeat karun kya?
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Okay.
No, ma'am. Samjha.
Achha, ab Jaya pooch rahi thi kya? Ki Annu pooch rahi thi?
Jaya.
Achha, theek hai. Jaya pooch rahi thi. Theek hai. अब देखो, अब कैलसी लो, कैलसी उठा हाथ में, ये देखो प्रपोर्शन की कॉलम में 16.25 है, कैलसी में डालो 16.25 इंटू फोर्थ कॉलम में क्या है 7। अब है ना बहुत सारे बच्चे मिस्टेक क्या करते हैं, सारे सुनो पहले, स्टूडेंट्स मिस्टेक क्या करते हैं, 16.25 इंटू 7 गलत, रॉन्ग। क्या करना है, 16.25 इंटू 7 परसेंटेज। You don't have to use multiply. You don't have to use the sign of equals to in the calci. Rather use percentage ka button. How you have to do? Please follow me. 16.25 into 7 percentage. So what is the answer?
1.1375.
But you have to put yes, only ma'am. 2 digits. You have to use only 2 digits after decimal. That therefore you have to round it off. So rounding it off means the third number is 7. So according to third number, the second number will be increased by one number. The second number is 3. It will be increased. Yes. So it is 1.14. What? 1.14 what?
Percent.
Percentage. Percent. Yes. Now second. Now second preferences. 8.75 into 8%. 8.75 into 8%.
0.7.
0.7.
Please remember to use percentage ka button. Next, what is 75 into 10%? Third, ECS. ECS is equity share.
No, 0.7. आपने फाइल लिखा है.
हाँ मैम, ऊपर वाला
यस, व्हाट इज इट,
चल चुप, 0.70
सेकंड डिजिट कुछ भी नहीं है
मैम, सेकंड वाला 0.7।
हाँ मैम,
तो आप लोग गलत कैसे बता रहे हो?
नहीं मैम, आपको वो बता रहे थे, आपने उसमें फाइव लिख दिया।
अच्छा ठीक है, 0.70 ये करेक्ट है क्या? करेक्ट है?
यस मैम।
यस मैम।
और इक्विटी शेयर कैपिटल का कितना है? 75% इनटू 10%। द अमाउंट इज 0.75।
हाँ मैम।
ओके, सो नाउ दिस इज नॉट बैक 1.14, 0.70, 0.7. This is not VAC. VAC is the total of all. VAC is the total of all. Remember this thing. What is the total of all? 1.14 plus 0.70 plus 0.75. What is the total? Guys, please tell me what is the total? 1.14 plus 0.70 plus 0.75. What is the answer?
2.85%.
No, wrong. You are giving me, you can't do total. आप लोगों ने भी ये भी रॉन्ग है, रॉन्ग है, रॉन्ग है। आपने मुझे क्या बताया, 75 का 10% 0.75 होता है?
7.5 होगा मैम वो।
फिर आप लोग मुझे क्या बता रहे हो, आ नहीं रहा है कैलसी यूज करने तुम लोगों को? कैलसी यूज कर रहे हो कि दिमाग यूज कर रहे हो? मुझे पता है तुम्हारा दिमाग नहीं चलता है। प्लीज गाइज यूज कैलसी। 75% into 10%. 75 into 10%. It is 7.5. And now give me the total. Come on, give me total. 1.14 plus 0.70 plus 7.5.
Ma'am, second one is 0.7.
I know second one is 0.7, beta. It is correct only. 0.7. You can write it as 0.70 because second
okay, ma'am, okay.
Decimal, you want 2 digits, beta. After decimal, you want 2 digits. So second digit is not there. Assume it as zero. See, you say 0.7 okay. or you say 0.70. It is one and the same thing. There is no such difference.
Okay.
Okay, Diya? Yes. So it is 1.14 plus 0.70 plus 7.50. What is the total?
9.34.
9.34 what?
Percent.
Yes.
Percentage.
So this is what is my VAT. And this is my VAT. And you have to copy this and write it at the last line. Sorry. So this is the way you have to write. See? See the way I'm writing here. Therefore, you have to use the sign of therefore. Huh? Therefore, VAT is equal to 9.34%. This should be the last line of any practical sum that you are doing. This should be the last final line, concluding line. Therefore, VAT is equal to 9.34%. And this is how the table has to be constructed. The first column, sources. Second column, amount, which is already given. Proportion is the next column. COC is the next column. VAT is the last column. Formula of VAT is proportion into COC percentage. Proportion into COC percentage. This is the formula of VAT. How to calculate proportion? I hope you understood. Each amount has to be divided by total multiplied with 100. Each amount has to be divided by total. Multiply it with 100. You will get proportion of each of the sources which are given here. After getting sources, you will have to write down COC. For COC, if nothing has been given, then you have to apply the formula. Okay. Are you getting my point?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this is how you have to solve. Okay, so last, in the last column, last row, VAT is equals to 9.34. This is known as VAT. 1.14, 0.70, 7.50 is not VAT. The VAT is always, remember, VAT is total of all, weighted average cost of capital. Average is the total of all. Considering the total of all according to their weights, according to their proportions, we have calculated total percentage. And that is known as VAT. Is it clear, everybody? And try to use,
yes, ma'am.
Be keen while using calculators. Even after doing it in the CalC, you are not doing it properly. I mean, I did not ask you to tell me orally. Do it properly, no? In exam, there is only one time that you are attempting the question. There is no another, after completing your paper, submitting the paper, you will realize, oh my God, I've written 0.75. And that's wrong. I should have written 7.5. You cannot redo that, no? You cannot ask me to give that paper again and you will rectify your mistake. No, you cannot. Here you can rectify. In the paper, you cannot. Please be very keen while using calculator. Okay, copy down the sum. We will wind up with the lecture. Have you copied down?
Yes,
Shall we wind up with the lecture?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. We will continue in next lectures. Okay, with the practical sums only.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, everybody. Take care.